Hey everyone, welcome to Control System Lectures. In the previous video, we had discussed about the Lyapunov stability theorem. Although the second method of Lyapunov has the advantage that it gives the stability without actually solving the system equations, it's a major hurdle to determine the Lyapunov function v of x which satisfies the conditions in the theorem. That is, we need to find a v of x which is positive definite, and a v dot x which is either negative definite or negative semi-definite. Whether v dot x is negative definite or negative semi-definite depends on the theorem we use. Okay, so the major issues in determining the stability of a nonlinear system are choosing a suitable Lyapunov function that can prove the stability. Not only that, the Lyapunov function thus chosen should have a maximum region of stability if the equilibrium state is not globally stable. Unfortunately, the complete answers for these issues are not available. However, we will study two of the significant methods available for choosing a Lyapunov function for a nonlinear system. In this video, we will study the first method, that is Krasovsky's method. Consider a system x dot equal to f of x, where x is an n-dimensional vector. Also assume that the origin is an equilibrium point, that is f of 0 will be 0 and f of x should be differentiable with respect to each component of x. Okay, in that case, the Jacobian matrix for the system is given by f of x equal to dou f by dou x equal to dou f1 by dou x1, dou f1 by dou x2, etc. to dou f1 by dou xn, and similarly dou fn by dou x1, etc. to dou fn by dou xn. This is the Jacobian matrix for system. Now we define a function f cap x equal to f star x plus f of x, where f star x is the conjugate transpose of f of x. Then, according to Krasovsky's theorem, if f cap x is negative definite, then the equilibrium state at origin is asymptotically stable. And the Lyapunov function for the system is v of x equal to f star x into f of x, where f star x is the conjugate transpose of f of x. Also, if v of x tends to infinity, as mod x tends to infinity, then the equilibrium state at origin is asymptotically stable in the large. So, that is Krasovsky's theorem. If f cap x is negative definite, then the equilibrium state at x equal to 0 is asymptotically stable. But why so? We will see the proof for that. Proof. If f cap x is negative definite for all x, then the determinant of f cap x is non-zero everywhere except at origin. That is, determinant of f cap x is equal to 0 at x equal to 0 and non-zero at x not equal to 0. Also, since f of 0 equal to 0 and f of x not equal to 0 for all x not equal to 0, we can infer that v of x will be positive definite. And here v of x is equal to f star x into f of x. Now, from this expression, we can obtain v dot x equal to f star dot x into f of x plus f star x into f dot x. Also note that f dot x is equal to dou f by dou x into dou x by dou t, which is equal to f of x into x dot. And we have defined the system as x dot equal to f of x. Therefore, this expression become f of x into f of x. Therefore, we can modify this expression as v dot x equal to f of x into f of x the whole star into f of x plus f star x into f of x into f of x, which will be equal to f star x into f star x plus f of x into f of x, which will come out as f star x into f cap x into f of x. From this expression, we can infer that if f cap x is negative definite, then v dot x will be negative definite. Let me write that down. F cap x is negative definite implies v dot x is negative definite. So, if f cap x is negative definite, then according to Krasovsky's theorem, if we choose a v of x equal to f star x into f of x, then v dot x will be negative definite and v of x will be positive definite. Therefore, the system is Lyapunov stable. Okay, now let's see an example where we use the Krasovsky's theorem to determine the stability of a system. So, the system is given by x1 dot equal to minus x1 and x2 dot equal to x1 minus x2 minus x2 cube. So, we will write f1 of x equal to minus x1 and f2 of x equal to x1 minus x2 minus x2 cube, which gives us f of x equal to minus x1 and x1 minus x2 minus x2 cube. Now, to find the Jacobian matrix, dou f1 by dou x1 equal to minus 1, dou f1 by dou x2 equal to 0, dou f2 by dou x1 equal to 1, dou f2 by dou x2 equal to minus 1 minus 3 x2 square. Therefore, Jacobian matrix f of x equal to dou f by dou x will be minus 1, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 3x2 square. So, we can calculate f cap x equal to f star x plus f of x, which will be minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 3x2 square plus minus 1, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 3x2 square, which is equal to minus 2, 1, 1, minus 2, minus 6x2 square, which is equal to minus of 2, minus 1, minus 1, 2 plus 6x2 square. Now we need to check whether f cap x is negative definite or not. For that, we need to check for the principal determinants of the matrix 2 minus 1 minus 1 2 plus 6x2 square. Therefore, the matrix is 2 minus 1 minus 1 2 plus 6x2 square. And we will see the first principal determinant, that is 2 and is positive definite. Now we will see the second principal determinant, that is 2 minus 1 minus 1 2 plus 6 x2 square, which will be 4 plus 12 x2 square minus 1, which is 12 x2 square plus 3, and this is positive definite. So we can conclude that the matrix 2 minus 1 minus 1 2 plus 6 x2 square is positive definite, which means that the negative of this matrix, that is F cap X, is negative definite. Therefore, the Lyapunov function V of X is given by V of X equal to F star X into F of X, which will be X1 square plus X1 minus X2 minus X2 cube square. You can check it out yourself. Once you evaluate F star X into F of X, you will get this expression. Okay. So you can see that V of X is positive definite and F cap X is negative definite, which implies that the system is stable according to Krasovsky's theorem. Furthermore, we can see that V of X tends to infinity as mod X tends to infinity. Therefore, we can say that the equilibrium state is asymptotically stable in the large. We will conclude our lecture here, and in the next video, we will discuss about the variable gradient method of generating a Lyapunov function. If you have any doubts in this video, please ask them in the comment section. And also support us by liking the video and subscribing the channel. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.